I tested two Kamigami programmable insect robots for kids using the downloadable app and battle mode. The battery-operated Kamigami praying mantis, or mantix, is just like the Scarex that I reviewed a couple weeks ago. They both come unassembled, so building them and programming them is all part of the fun. This build-it-yourself robot platform is just basically a simple snap and build system. It is controlled by an app that is downloaded at the Apple Store for iPhone and the Google Play Store for Android. So if you're inexperienced in coding these STEM toy robots, Mattel made it very easy with the in-app drag and drop system of coding your robot, and you'll have them up and running in no time. It's very simple, and it'll keep you entertained as well. It's quite fun going through all the options. If you want to see a more detailed review of Kamigami robots, I reviewed the Scarex about 2 weeks ago. You can check it out. It goes into more detail about the building and the coding as well, so make sure you check it out. I include a link for you. So the whole reason we bought the second robot was to see the robot-to-robot interaction and check out the battle mode. It did look pretty cool in the box, so let's check it out and see what we think about it. So we've been using our green mantix here, the praying mantis, for a little bit, and one noticeable difference is that he doesn't tip over quite as easy as the scorpion, the Scarex. When he does tip over, his little clippers or his little hands or whatever they're in the front by his head prevent him from flipping over quite as easy, whereas the scorpion will fall over if his tail comes down or if he just gets off balance. But the scorpion does look cooler in slow motion with his arms flapping and his tail flapping around. My daughter's doing the video here, and she's quite a trooper trying to keep up with this thing. They are fast. So I'm impressed just how fast these things are, and also with the body of the build, the quality of the legs. They haven't come apart. We have really been rough on both of these robots. We've crashed them into everything, and they've been perfectly fine. I've been trying for a while now to flip this thing over, and it doesn't turn over quite as easy. But every once in a while, he'll flip over if you get him on an uneven surface.
Go forward.
One thing that I have been a little disappointed about was the connectivity between the two robots whenever you put them both together or if they're in close range. The green one will just sometimes take off running down the driveway on his own. Now the connectivity issue could have something to do with the quality
of
tablet that we were using. I was using a Samsung and the other tablet was an Amazon Kindle.
A little update to my Scarex. In the previous video, you may have seen the tail will fall down either side and kind of throw him off balance sometimes. So I added a piece of tape to hold that tail in place. It works.
Set. Go.
So here's our driveway race. It's kind of like in a free play mode. And we're having a little bit of an issue with connectivity. They kind of do whatever they want to do. It can be tricky to make your robot go in a straight path because any slight movement of your finger on the tablet to change its direction is exaggerated by the movement of the robot. So we kept crashing into each other. So what we do is put each robot on either side one of the squares on the driveway, and then the first one to cross the other line was the winner.
Hold on.
Oh, he won.
My favorite flooring to run this robot is probably a carpet or like an area rug. They do slide a lot on smooth surfaces, and our cat is obsessed with this robot. I'm not sure why.
In battle mode, it's difficult to shoot, to use your little gun and move at the same time. I don't know if you really can. So what we'd have to do is move into position and then use the gun to shoot at the other robot. And you can see, it does look like one robot will shoot while the other one, you can hear like that tink tink sound. If you can hear that. And my son did find a way to cheat. Instead of his health going down, he would back out of the battle mode and go back into it for full health.
You cheater! He backed out and got full health. That's it, I'm ramming you. That's it. If I can move.
So my overall impression of the battle mode is don't buy it for battle mode. Just due to connectivity issues, and the fact that you have to stand still to shoot your laser at the other robot is kind of silly. But the positives far outweigh the negatives. This robot, single person play is excellent. I would buy it again. I would recommend it for anybody. But as far as battle mode, no. So the robot does look neat. It's very durable. It has high quality parts. It's put together very well. It's very well designed. The dances are neat in the app, and the coding is really, really neat as well. It does give you the ability to change the lights, to make it blink different colors, to make it do different actions, and to make different sounds and stuff. So it is entertaining, and it will keep you occupied, and you know, the younger children, it'll entertain them as well. Another thing we like about it is these things are really quick. They're quick and they're fun to watch. So that's my take on Kamigami robots. I think they're really cool. Let me know if you have one, what you think about it, or maybe you're thinking about getting one, whether you agree or disagree. Let's hear what you have to say. Just feel free to leave a comment.
Well, that's all I've got for now. So as always, I thank you for watching. I hope you follow the channel so you can catch our upcoming videos, and we'll see you next time.